On the last episode of What We Know, we talked about developers responding to questions, and there was a lot of them. That video was nearly 20 minutes, holy cow. But now we're gonna be moving on to the next one. So here we go.
Get down! Hands in the air!
Civilian is safe, secure, and ready for evac.
Police! Put your hands up! Get down! Hands in the air!
So I read a comment on Ready or Not's Reddit about DRM, and I thought that this would be a fun topic to discuss. Now, what is DRM? DRM stands for Digital Rights Management, and I'm just going to let Google explain.
According to Wikipedia, digital rights management is a set of access control technologies for restricting the use of proprietary hardware and copyrighted works.
Basically, the point of the program is to ward off pirating. Now, the idea sounds good on paper, but when implemented, it seems to be poorly thought out because of all the hoops that players have to jump through. For example, always having to be online. Honestly, I wouldn't mind this feature, but the problem is that the internet really sucks in the US. Like, almost every day, the frickin' internet goes out on me, like, it's just not good, Having to jump through a lot of hoops just to share a game, if that's even an option. In order for you to play this game, you must have this required setting. Another thing that makes this system bad is that you don't get physical copies of games, so in order for you to play it, you have to be on their servers. And what happens if those servers one day go offline? We on PC have that issue with Steam. If one day it decides to go offline, I think me and most others will have a gigantic problem because that's a lot of money down the drain. It's literally like communism.
All these games are yours in theory, comrade. But in the end, you still have to go back to the gulag. Go back into the Metro Artium.
But we're going way the hell off topic, so I'll start by reading what was on the Reddit itself. Will this game have DRM? No argument for or against it. Would just like to know. And the developer replied with, nothing outside of checking if the game is owned on Steam via our own methods, which is seamless if you own it. No third-party DRM. Alright, cool. Thanks. I hope this doesn't mean always online though. And the developer replied to that one, saying, nah, no always online. You'll be able to play offline after you launch the game online at least once. And then another person replies to that one, saying, sorry for not contributing to the discussion. I just wanted to let you know how much I appreciate your style of communication with your fans. I hope your game succeeds. And the developer replies with, thanks. I appreciate your appreciation. I feel honored to have an opportunity to be bringing you guys Ron. We know this game is going to succeed because it's built by passionate people, gamers, who have enjoyed all the early tactical games and have the right skill set, tools, and vision to pull off a modern tactical shooter. You guys have all been dying to play long before you knew about Ready or Not. You know, I really like how the developers are responding to a lot of people on this Reddit, but I don't think that they respond to almost everybody because I think a majority of them are answered by the community itself. That's why I don't see a whole lot of, the devs are always coming in and answering almost every question. But yeah, once again, this was just another quick video that I thought that I would show you guys, and just to warn you about DRM. I believe that Microsoft was also trying to do this with the consoles, and I was so glad that there was a gigantic backlash for this. So I guess I will catch you in the next one. Bye-bye. Oh, be sure to join the Discord if you want to, you know, talk to me, because I'm almost always on it, so. Yeah, link in the description. All right, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.